Hi. In V-Ray 6, Chaos Group decided to remove the quad menu. When you right click, you had these options here. And the only thing that is left is the V-Ray properties. Now, in this video, we will see how we can bring back these items in the quad menu. These features now, if you want to find them, you have to go to V-Ray menu. And you can see them here. But if you like the old quad menu, we will add it now. Now, before doing that, we need to check on a file called V-Ray install.ms and see if it's writable or read-only. If it's read-only, you have to uncheck read-only and click OK. Because the changes we will make, the quad menu that we will add, it will be written here, and we don't want to, you know, when we add the quad menu and then restart Max, we don't want this quad menu to disappear. Now, I'm using Max 2023, so this file here, you should look for it in the program data, Autodesk application plugins, V-Ray 3D Studio Max 223, and then in a folder called scripts, and you will see it here. If you are on a Max 2020 or 2021, you need to look in the programs, Autodesk, here I have the 220, and then in scripts, and in startup, and here you'll have this V-Ray install.ms, and this also goes for the 2021. Now for the 2022, you have to look for C program data, Autodesk application plugins, V-Ray 3D Studio Max 2022 scripts. So after doing that, now to add the quad menu, first, for example, let's add the V-Ray scene converter. We go to Customize User Interface, Quads tab, here in the category, look for V-Ray. For the V-Ray converter, check this option here, convert all scene materials to V-Ray material and all ray trace shadows to V-Ray shadows. And I will add this to the transform quad here. When you right click, these options were here in the transform quad. So here, click and drag . I will close and test it now. You can see here V-Ray scene converter, and you can have all these options again. Now again, I will add the mesh exporter, which is creating proxies. You have to look for export selected meshes to an external file. As you can see, the names here are different than in the quad menu. So, but this is it, you know. So just click it and drag here. Now let's test it again. Right click, and as you can see, it will take the old name here. V-Ray Mesh Exporter. Now we will add the scene exporter. For the scene exporter, you have to look for export the current view to a .vray scene file. As you can see here, it's V-Ray scene exporter. And you can add as much commands as you like this way. Okay, now let's close and reopen Max to see if the quad menu remains. And yes, it is still here. And that's it for this tutorial. Hope you like it. And if you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you in the next video. Thank you.